Hey everyone, welcome back to my garden, and I wanted to talk about some interesting things today. If you look right over here in front of me on this plant right over here, this is a borage plant, and I planted this from seed, and I wanted to show you the difference between LED lights versus T5 fluorescence, and so you can really see the difference for yourself and decide for yourself what you think works best. If you look at this plant, let's start with this one. You could see basically that the leaves over here, they're looking a tiny bit yellowish and has some discoloration, but overall looks pretty healthy. Let's actually lift it up and take a look at what the root system looks like. So not too bad, nice and white. Looks overall pretty healthy, but not as big as I thought it would be. Now let's actually take a look at what this is being run under the T5s. These are fluorescent grow lights. Now, if we lift this plant up right over here, this is also a borage plant. However, look at the difference in the leaf structure, the size difference of the leaves, and more importantly, the color of how this plant looks. Both of these plants were planted at the exact same time, and they germinated at the same time, so they've actually been growing, and pretty much the same way. The only difference is this plant here is under T5s, and this plant right here was grown under my LED lights, which is a Mars 300. And all the items will be in the description bar above, so you could click and see what it looks like for yourself. And let's lift this up and see what the root system looks like. Now overall it looks just about the same, however this one I could see that the root system actually is a lot bigger and looks a tiny bit whiter than the one that we previously just looked at under the T5s. So I think overall these LED lights are a big help, and when I used to grow borage, I've never had such elongated leaves before. They're actually nice and big, they look very healthy. Look at this beautiful green. Now let's look at this one right over here, yellow. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to put all of these herbs into my LED grow lights, and I might even get another LED grow light to replace a T5, because it seems like the plant speaks for itself, and honestly I couldn't be happier with the results, and I did not expect it to be such a drastic difference. But yeah, I mean that's what you have when you grow different lights. And this was basically on the T5s, were always about 3 to 4 inches above the grow lights, when under the LEDs this plant is maybe like, I would say maybe 2 feet, maybe even 3 feet underneath the grow lights, probably more so closer to 2 feet. And look at that, the difference shows itself. So I'm gonna keep this plant growing, and we'll be back soon for some other future episodes. And real quick, I just wanted to show you before we go, this plant right over here, I'm extremely excited about. This is going to be an all-female cucumber. All the flowers that are going to be produced will be all females, so I'm going to be able to get a ton, and I mean a ton of cucumbers. When I seen the photo of this plant growing, there were so many cukes all over the place. And also one more thing, this plant right here, that's a ground cherry plant, and I wanted to show you something exciting. Let's lift this up. Look at that, roots, the bottom and the side. So that means you could take a clipping off of your ground cherry plant, stick it in the ground or in some soil or coco core like I am, and that's how you propagate a ground cherry plant. So that definitely works. And I'm going to put all of these plants under the LED grow lights and see what happens. So as always, don't forget to hit the thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching.